The most beautiful thing about a sunrise is its patience. The way it rolls over the horizon one strand at a time. The way its back breaks over the curved slope of sky. The way it bleeds red until there is no more darkness and the day is born. I met the sun once, and she was my mother. And she named me kin, named me child, named me sky, told me of how the slope of her back bent and broke around my curved shape, of how she bled red until I could see no more darkness and I was born. Some days, I don't know if I'm just following in her footsteps or just beginning to become myself. I am not the center of the universe, but I will not be convinced that the sun doesn't revolve around me, that she'll ever leave me without love or light or guidance. That she'll ever fail to teach me that I am the sky, and the sky is just the ocean where suns are born. She shows me her spots, the tiny volcanoes that erupt beneath the surface of her skin, and tells me that the sun is a servant of the skies, is the anchor of her family, is the one who lights herself on fire to keep those she loves warm. She is hope and purpose, and the guiding light that taught me that I exist outside darkness. To be the sun is to ignore your own pain. To know your name will not be carried on, but forgotten. To clothe yourself until the distant skies cannot tell you apart from any other sun, but you know that every other sun is just as important as you are. And there are many suns. And there are many homes that hold solar systems until our cities glow and forget what cold and dark and lonely feel like. And it is when suns come together, and our dreams turn to constellations painted on the backs of young night skies, that those we have loved and those we have lost find their way home.